People have been using plastic for about 50 years due to its convenient features. It's light, durable, and cheap. But plastic does not decompose for a long time and can cause environmental contamination. It takes about 50 years for styrofoam to decompose, about 400 years for vinyl bags, and more than 600 years for thick plastic. So far, we have produced a total of 8.3 billion tons of plastic, and 79% of that, a whopping 6.3 billion tons, was wasted. After being thrown into the sea, those plastic products have been discovered in the stomachs of ocean creatures. Why are ocean creatures consuming the plastic? According to a study from Science Advance in 2016, phytoplankton multiply by adhering to pieces of plastic or the surfaces of vinyl bags. Then, the sea creatures mistake the plastic products as edible due to the smell from the phytoplankton. A growing concern has been the crisis of microplastics, which are tiny pieces of plastic called nurdle, which have a diameter between 1 micrometer and 5 millimeters. The microbeads in cosmetics and toothpaste and tiny broken plastic pieces are creating the microplastic. Nurdle sinks to the bottom of the water and is consumed by ocean creatures with their food. Nurdle threatens marine algae, coral reefs, and oysters, as well as other ocean creatures. According to an experiment by the French Research Institute for Exploitation of the Sea, IFREMER, oysters which inhabit water with polystyrene particles have 35% fewer ova than normal, and spermatozoa movement has slowed down by 23%. The threat to ocean creatures and humans is not fully known as research on the nurdle crisis continues. The World Wildlife Fund, WWF, commissioned a study on plastics that was carried out by the University of Newcastle, Australia. Prepared by Dahlberg, the analysis was entitled No Plastic in Nature, Assessing Plastic Ingestion from Nature to People. It suggests that people are consuming about 2,000 tiny pieces of plastic every week, adding up to an estimated 5 grams, which means we have been consuming the equivalent of a credit card every single week. This microplastic is often ingested through drinking water. Microplastic is detected in 81% of the tap water in the world. It has also been discovered that shellfish, beer, and salt retain a high degree of microplastic. Due to these serious problems, bills restraining microplastics have been passed globally. In the U.S., the Microbead Free Waters Act of 2015 prohibited the addition of plastic microbeads in the manufacturing of certain personal care products washed with water. The EU approved the replacement of disposable plastic products with renewable, eco-friendly material by 2021, and that 90% of plastic bottles should be recycled by 2025. Scientists have started applying synthetic biology to find ways to resolve the problem of long-lasting decomposition of plastic garbage. They look for microorganisms and enzymes in nature that decompose plastic and analyze how they do it. Research on microorganisms decomposing polyethylene, PE, most commonly used in daily life, was started in 2010. In 2017, researchers in the UK and Spain found out that waxworms, worms of wax moths, can process polyethylene at 1,400 times the speed of natural decomposition. In 2016, Japanese researchers discovered bacteria that can decompose PET, polyester. Also, research on the intestinal microorganisms of mealworms eating polystyrene, PS, is currently ongoing. Once this research enables us to create artificial microorganisms to decompose diverse types of plastics, it will be easier to dispose of plastic garbage. On another front, biodegradable plastic is an exciting option as an alternative to current plastics. When buried, biodegradable plastic is decomposed 100% naturally. Biodegradable plastics can be made from naturally occurring polymers, such as starch, chemically occurring polymers, and microbiologically occurring polymers. For example, one biodegradable plastic is PLA, polylactic acid, which is a synthetic polymer made from corn. Its price and features are similar to existing plastic, so it is the material most commonly used commercially. Scientists of the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich, ETH Zurich, and the Swiss Federal Institute of Aquatic Science and Technology, EAWAG, studied how microorganisms decompose PBAT plastic, a biodegradable substitute for polyethylene vinyl. They found that the PBAT was biodegraded by soil microbes and disappeared harmlessly after decomposition. Due to these research results, biodegradable plastics are excluded from certain regulations, and demand for them is growing more than 20% each year. The more the research on plastic substitutes and plastic decomposition continues, the safer the Earth will be.